actually doing some pre-scouting. I'm out here scouting some places here before those guys get to camp. I'm beginning to think I am in the right spot. There's a really nice yellow phase right there. Pretty close to him. Just gonna get out of here, let him go back. Oh boy, that's a big one. That's a big one. Looky there. Boy, that's a nice looking snake. He's big too. Wow. But want to try to get him off the road. I'd say that's a legal male. He's got real nice color for a black face. Just coming up to camp. We're gonna save rattlesnake. Get off into the brush. And there he goes. He's gone. He's getting off. Get off the road. Don't be coming back on here. Getting hit. Luke Nugent, what are you cooking?
Oh, we got some sausage links.
Oh,
we got some sausage patties. We got the eggs whipped up. We're going to have some scrambled eggs, some toast, and we're going to have a nice breakfast before
nice.
We head out.
You ready for snake camp?
I am. Good time to be at snake season. We got the whole crew here. Everybody's invited.
Looks good.
Elk. Yeah, that's where he went in right there. So he could be anywhere around here. Well, the snake wasn't here today. Well, we're a little bit farther away and Brian spotted a big yellow face. Oh man, look at that snake. Look at those rattles. Yeah, grab them just, you can see how they want to get away. Yep, just bring them over here. Want to bring them over here in the shade. Yep, just keep bringing them over.
Look how black the end of the tail is.
Man, that's a beautiful snake. Wow. Yep, just bring him over here in this little area right here in the shade. See if we can get him coiled up here. Now he just lost a little bit of his rattle. Because when he first started rattling, he had two buttons that were on his rattle that were just getting ready to come off. That has to be the big snake that I seen. He's got a pretty nice rattle. You can see how he already stopped rattling. We don't have that much pressure on the tongs. We're just lightly holding them in place.
Get right with.
All right, Brian. So what do you want to do? You found him. Is it going to be your first snake to tag out?
Well, let's tube him up and see what he comes in at.
All right, we'll do that. You want to tube him or you want me to tube him?
I'll let you take that one.
Okay. Okay, so in the state of Pennsylvania, a snake has to be a male and it has to be 42 inches long. So what we want to do is, this is just a fluorescent light tube guard. You can buy at your local hardware store, cut it to length. Go So what we want to do, this can be sometimes difficult depending on how the snake wants to cooperate. But we just want to try to get his head started up in this hole. Just like that. Now sometimes you can use the tong if you need to. Now once it's in the tube, you want to try to be in the shade if you don't have the ability to be in the shade, because this creates a lot of heat inside the tube and it can put a lot of stress on the snake. So anyways, what we're going to do, as you can see, how one indication that we can tell that this is a male is see how the snake, the whole way down its body, is a long, nice taper. That's an indication of a male. A female will come out like this wide and then quickly pinch down right before the vent. So if we can visibly notice that the snake is wide and then tapers down quickly, it's a sign that it's probably a female, and it's an indication we may not want to handle that snake in case it is a gravid female. But we have good indication because of just looking at it that it is a male. So here's the subcaudal scales. These scales underneath studies the majority of all male snakes will usually have 21 or more. It's considered male. So we start at the vent here and we count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. Like the manufacturer? 24. So this has 24 subcaudal scales. 21 is the minimum. So this is definitely a
male
legal snake. And let's do the measurement here.
I'm going to go with probably like 47, so, 48.
Want to try to pinch the tube to get up as far as we can. Try to get all the kinks out. Got more kinks.
I get a lot of kinks.
Yeah. There's 45, 46, 47.
Okay.
I saw 47.
Yeah.
There. Try it right there.
I mean, he's 48. He's 48 inches easily.
All right, Brian. You wanted to tag him out?
Absolutely. Beautiful snake.
All right.
That's
congrats.
Awesome.
Look at that snake. Big fat one too. We're actually going to bag the snake, but if you weren't going to bag one, here's the best way to let it go. Just lay it down like this. Let this hand go first and just throw it behind your back like this. And just let it go. That's the best way to let a snake go.
All right. Nice snake.
He's
first snake too.
Yep.
First snake. Beautiful yellow face. Couldn't ask for a better snake for first
gorgeous.
Snake ever. That's awesome. So glad you found him.
Yeah, nearly 50 inches.
Yeah, look at that.
Big old rattle on him.
Oh man.
He's beautiful.
Oh. All right, congrats.
The advanced scouting did its work.
Yeah, it did. It did.
What's weird is, your snake last year, like when I saw him, I was like, oh, he's not legal. He's not as thick as John's was. Because yours was like.
Mine might have been girthy, but man, you have 4 inches on you.
Now look, you can note it. Look at how we're all standing around. The snake is not trying to attack us.
It quit rattling.
It already stopped rattling. We've already tubed the snake. We're just getting pictures of it before we actually put it in a pillow sack, because that's how we take them home with us. They're not out there trying to kill people. They're not out there trying to attack people. So if you see them, you know, just try to let them go, especially if you see them on the roads. Just try to, you know, you don't have to get a stick to move them off the road. Just go around them and just try to leave them be. This is an important animal in Pennsylvania. And, you know, whether you choose to harvest a snake, take a snake, what we have to all do as snake hunters is to show and teach the new generation of snake hunters, because when I first started snake hunting, you could have taken any snake, male, female, no matter what length. And as the more snake hunters became evident in the state and that they found out there was actually more snakes, they wanted to try to protect those females and just take the biggest males. This snake is at least 15 years old. I mean, these are really, really old snakes, and it takes such a long time for these snakes to get to this size. So it's no small thing when we tag a snake, but at the same time, we want to teach the new generation that's coming out how to handle the snakes. So if you do catch one that you don't want to keep, you're not injuring it, and it end up not being able to eat what it needs to eat because of broken ribs or a, you know, crushed head or something like that. But there are rules and ethics papers that used to come with the Pennsylvania rattlesnake license. They no longer currently, as of 2020, now that we can buy our license over the counter anywhere, instead of sending in for a permit, they don't send us the papers of the ethics anymore. I highly, highly suggest you get on the Fish and Boat Commission and look up the ethics of rattlesnake hunting. I really wish they would start handing those out just like your hunting digest, you know, of the regulations, but they don't do that. And there's a lot of people that are improperly handling snakes, and we as experienced snake hunters need to, with respect and gentleness and kindness, lead these people, the newcomers, into a, I guess, quality snake management type of style of hunting. And as I'm still here talking, look at this snake. He's just perfectly content being right here with all of us, just hanging out. And Mr. Snake found a good spot with a little bit of shade, a little bit of sun, and he's just gonna soak it all up. Really think about how we hunt and how we portray ourselves on social media and on Facebook. Look out for one another and teach one another about the ins and outs of rattlesnake and what they actually mean for the state of Pennsylvania, because we're so fortunate here to have a season. Very dangerous part right here. Some guys do carry buckets, a little bit easier, but we're gonna do it with a sack. This is the way I've always done it. So you can let go of that. Then I hold this up. What I wanna do is I wanna bring this the whole way up and try to work the sack and the snake and the tube down in. So sometimes I'll bring it down. So as long as I have the snake, I'm using both my hands inside and I can feel the tube. And I wanna bring my hands up around so that when I just let go, drop it down, shake it, pull the tube out. You know the head is down there. Like that. Now we don't have to get it super tight, but you gotta do that at least to get a knot in it. We'll put our foot here. We'll wrap this up really tight so we can get a knot.
You guys saw the button come off the snake?
Johnny said he did, I didn't.
Well, it was dangling, and then it wasn't there when
I'd
saw it again.
I'd love to find his button so he can clip it back on.
Okay,
I mean, we've been walking
and that
all over it.
Is how we take the snake home, and we put that in your backpack, or some guys would just carry it with their tongs away from them if you're not comfortable with it in your backpack. Okay, so I don't know much about fossils, but that does look like a fossil to me. So does anybody know what, you know, that could be? Leave a comment under the video if you'd happen to know what it could be. Just kind of looks interesting. Okay.
Look at that yellow phase.
They're,
whoa, there's one right there.
Black phase. Where's it at?
What?
Right there. Yeah, where'd it go?
Grab
that one, Sweeney. Okay. Pull them out here. Yep, just bring them out here into the open. It's a little one that I saw yesterday. That one's probably not legal.
What do you think this one is? If he is, he's close.
That one there's gonna be close to being legal. Maybe.
Close.
Try to... Okay. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
Nope, it's a female.
Let me count again.
16, 17, 18,
19, 20.
It's a female.
Hold it right there.
See
your hand.
Yeah. I'd say probably 42, 43, 44. Probably 45.
44 and a half.
44 and a half. Okay. All right. Gonna let him go.
Yeah, what do I do with my tongs?
All right.
Ooh, hello.
It's not a legal snake because it doesn't have
The caudal scales.
The caudal scales. It's required. It's missing. If it had one more caudal scale, we checked twice. And so we can't keep that one. Right back. John's going to put the snake right back where he saw him.
So there was three right here.
Got some rough grouse. Good to see those. There was another one. It went off the road. All right, guys. The place that we're staying at is called the Bar None Lodge. It's located upstream from Hicks Run. We are in the heart of the wilderness here. I mean, if you want something that is secluded, really in the middle of the woods, there's elk sign. There's bear sign. Just down the road is Trout Stream. I mean, you have it all up here, and it's a great, great place. Look them up, Bar Top Rentals. We're just enjoying it so far. If you guys are interested in renting this place, be sure to check out their other rentals, such as Camp Critter, we stayed at last year. Awesome place. The Bull Hollow Lodge and the Spring View Lodge, all within the elk range. And I can hear the rattlesnake on the porch. You guys are coming out. We got the rattlesnake that Brian caught on the porch in our homemade rattlesnake box. We're gonna check it out.
Welcome to the show.
I just found this one right here. It's a yellow face. Very, very dark. You can see how much black is on it. Very short rattle. But it's got a lot of scale rot on it. You could... Well, my camera malfunctioned. Just went blurred out for some reason. So, oh well. But we're in a new spot. We heard one buzzing underneath this rock here. And there's one right here laying beside this one. All right, John. What are we having?
So you guys might have watched a video last year of where I spined me a doe. Up in Johnny's food plot. These are hindquarter deer steaks cut from that said doe.
Nice.
Just Italian dressing with a 48-hour marinade.
Oh, this is a very intricate dish. You're going to want to pay attention to this. This is called bloxed macaroni and cheese.
Macaroni?
Nice.
What should this be?
Okay. I'll finish off if you don't get it all.
We decided not to go fishing today. We hit one more spot, found just a couple snakes. Decided to just come back and just hang out at camp and just enjoy sitting by the fire and put a lot of miles on today, so we're sort of worn out, but I'm telling you, this place is awesome. Peaceful. I'm just touching the tip of the iceberg, but we're having such a good time right here by the fire, just enjoying ourselves, and this is where we'll be probably for rest of the night, unless we decide to challenge each other to a game pool. All right, well, it's Saturday morning. We just finished up eating breakfast. The guys are inside getting their snake boots on. They'll be coming out the door any minute. Go up and try to find some snakes this morning before it gets too hot. It's supposed to get up into the 90s, and the hotter it gets a little bit tougher to find the snakes. But today will be the last day we hunt. We're going to head out early tomorrow morning. And, if we're done by noon, we're just going to chill out, maybe go fishing or just stay inside the air conditioning. You ready?
Woo!
Ready for another
beautiful day.
Yeah.
It's gonna be a good day, Tater.
Let's get a little snake fishing going here. All right.
Yeah, make sure you have the fluids, huh?
These are nice 79-cent Powerades to get at the riverside.
Get your electrolytes right.
Tagged out. We just walk in here. We just walk through here. The sun's just starting to pop out. And we found one of the smallest straddle snakes that we've ever seen.
Just went like this. And I was like, I almost ran into him.
This thing is maybe only a year old, probably.
black face. Really good color on him. See how light the coloration is on him?
It's a nice
color. See if we can get him to... But look how fast he is.
At least he listens. No, I meant Sweeney.
He's got a lot of yellow in him for a black face, too. Yep.
Maybe he's a Blello.
Oh, that's it.
That snake couldn't stop high enough to strike you in the leg anyway.
No. All right, here's where we're going to eat lunch. Took a little detour out of the way. Beautiful view. So we went to a couple other places with no luck. Come back to camp. What are you talking about?
How excellent this weekend was. Our guide service was ridiculously good. Maybe we should get him sometime like
it's
we
pretty
do.
Pretty cheap, always.
Yeah. It's pretty cheap. Like, keep it real. Keeps it 100.
Comparison between last year and this year based on the hunts.
It helps that I'm 50 pounds less. That's a plus.
Yeah, you were chunker.
You were the Michelin man last year.
So we're heading out to another new spot, yeah.
Woo!
We don't know if it's worth it or not. You just barely see those guys.
Rock in this area.
Yeah, we got good rock. It's looking promising.
The ring.
Yeah, looking snakey. It's all right, we see some snakes. There's one there. There's a yellow phase right there, under the rock. Go up there and get him. Go ahead and get the yellow phase. Oh, that could be a legal snake. Bring him down here, out of the rock. Got him, Sweeney?
I got him.
All right.
Let go, John.
All right, leave him right here in the shade. You guys want to tube this one?
Sure.
Okay.
Dude, you're not getting him. He's
You're not going to get these other ones. All right, you don't have to zoom in or anything. Yeah.
He's okay. Got a great rattle.
Well,
other side, dude.
Oh. Ooh.
He has a nice rattle.
Yeah.
He's good coloration, too. Darker, but good coloration.
Okay.
All right, let me explain to you why we were all very close to this. So we're on top of this rock.
Totally a male.
Oh my goodness.
With
he's
nowhere
totally
to go.
He's totally a male.
Jordan, you want to count?
Yeah. Okay, there's the vent. He's being real. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25,
yep.
Maybe 26.
Yeah, you got definitely.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There's 11 buttons
yeah.
on him.
You're shaking.
Yeah, well, that one's a little, he's a little excited.
You have your,
grab the tape.
12 inches.
I would say that's not illegal.
Yeah, he's right at 40.
Nope.
You got a big,
beautiful snake, beautiful coloration.
Even with an extra kink,
no,
you're going to be pushing right on the border of 42 with what you have.
You know what, though?
And it's probably safer that we...
A couple more years, he could
let him go.
He could be a good one.
Let's see
so even though it could be a 42, it's too much on the line. And John's saying that he wants to let this one go to get bigger.
No bueno.
Really nice yellow face.
Good looking snake. Maybe a couple years we'll hit the spot again. He'll be
yeah.
a 50-inch snake.
All right, we're going to let him go.
Our room.
You can see.
Yeah, when he's sitting there,
He put that one. He put that one right there. If you look up in here, we're not going to go after this one.
There's two more up in there,
there's
but
one
we're
right
not
going
to reach up in the rocks and pull them out.
Oh,
we're
obviously not.
So, there was three snakes there. That was the biggest.
Yeah.
All right, we can keep looking around here.
Yep, there's one way back in there.
Oh, you can see. What in the world is that? Wait a minute. There's a different type of snake in here.
What?
There's a rattlesnake with another snake. I'm looking at three heads, and two are rattlesnakes, and one is not a rattlesnake. Come here, John, look at the camera.
It's a pit viper.
You know, it could have been a black racer or something like that.
I'm more concerned because they've all been laying on these rocks getting super hot.
There's the snake above you.
That's a huge snake.
That's a nice yellow face. That is a big snake. That is a big snake.
You have to get up in there.
Easy, John.
Go on.
1 second. Let's get up on top of the rock. Watch yourself.
Wow, John. Just...
Hey, I get off that rock. If you don't rock it.
He's a big guy.
Big guy.
Really disappointing.
Yep, but we tried to jump on the rock to videotape because we thought he was coming out this side, it sounded like, and we got on this side, and he's done rattling. He's like, I am right in the middle of this rock, and you are not getting me. I don't even need to rattle anymore. When a snake is under the rock, you don't want to reach in there and drag them and scrape them. It's just too hard on them. Sometimes if you just walk away, scout around, and come back in a half hour, they might be back out. But I don't know if we're gonna wait that long here just for that snake.
We're at 14.
At 14, okay, cool. 14, 2 days. Our goal is 20 snakes in 2 days.
We were at 8 yesterday, we now have 6 today.
We pushed off of there.
So we were here looking, and a snake was crossing from this rock John's on to this rock, and I don't know where it is. He's back in there somewhere, but it was a yellow face, but it was a small, it was not the same one.
What, maybe 30 inches?
Yeah, maybe.
So, I mean.
Definitely high 20s, low
30s. We can just look way back in there, and that other snake is still underneath there. And, you know, I don't think we're going to wait here that much longer.
We're at 14. That's now 15.
I missed a few in my mind, but we're there.
All right.
We're hitting our 20 mark. That's what we're doing.
All right. All right. We're heading out of here. Pretty good day. We're kind of talking about how we're seeing a little bit larger snakes than what we did the past 2 years. And like I said, we try to hit one or two familiar spots and always try to find a couple more new spots.
And they're all big boys.
What?
They're all yellowfin.
Every snake that we've found that's been in legal size or that we thought we couldn't get to that was a decent, you know, girthy snake from distance.
Yeah.
Every single one has been yellowfin so far. I really just want to write all over my thing. Caught Capnon, 50-inch yellow face. 15.
We gotta give them a good idea of how.
Where are they? Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. That's where they're at.
So that someday, yeah. Someday in the future, we could actually keep two for all this effort we're putting in. But we're not there yet. We got some time to go.
Yeah.
More miles to put in.
Yeah. Your wife will keep you home before that happens.
Yeah,
so Sweeney is, Luke is going to be married here in a couple weeks.
Tomorrow's the wedding shower, so I can't get fit or be late.
And we're out here in the middle of nowhere climbing around rattlesnake dens.
Fit and on time is acceptable, but fit or late is not good.
Okay.
No, your hand could be as big as a balloon, as long as you're there on time to help carry gifts.
And if I lose my left finger to a snake, I'm never going to hear the end of it, because we can't take cute pictures holding hands with rings on.
We can mold you a ring, or a ring finger out of clay.
Yeah, it'll pass.
Pretty he's cool.
Just, he's just up there hanging out.
Yeah.
Hanging out in a tree.
Nah.
He's like, what are these people doing?
Really nice snake.
That's a beautiful snake.
Yeah.
I mean, to pull them straight out of the wild like that, and they're already in that coloration.
Really nice snake.
We had a great time this weekend. Last night we just come back to camp and just hung out and relaxed. We hiked pretty good this weekend, and Brian was the only one that tagged out on a snake. We saw 15 snakes total, plus the rattlesnake we saw down the road crossing. We had a wonderful time this weekend. Bar None Lodge, if you guys are interested in possibly renting this place, look them up at bartoprentals.com.